We begin the evening with the felicitation. May I request Mr. Adi Godrej, President CII, to kindly felicitate the President of India, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, with a shawl. May I request Mr. Adi Godrej to give the welcome address, please.
Honorable Sri Pranab Mukherjee, President of India, Mr. Ajay Sriram, Vice President, CII, Mr. Chandrajit Banerjee, Director General, CII, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed a privilege for me to welcome Honorable Sri Pranab Mukherjee, President of India, to this felicitation program. CII is deeply privileged, sir, that you have accepted our invitation despite other demands on your time. This reiterates the immense goodwill and support that you have always extended to Indian industry and to CII. I take this opportunity to congratulate you on behalf of all of us present here today on assumption of the office of President of India. It is indeed a fitting extension of your outstanding and distinguished career in public service. The country is proud to have an erudite and intellectual person of your stature as head of state, a person who can effectively guide and mentor the nation, a person who can continue to contribute to the nation in this office as you have always done over the years. Sir, above all qualities, the one that has appealed to us is your ability to connect with people across the country and across social strata. Therefore, it is no wonder that we have people from every state in the country present here today. From Jammu and Kashmir in the north, to Kerala in the south, from Maharashtra and Gujarat in the west, to West Bengal and Orissa in the east, from the states of the Northeast, including Arunachal, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Mizoram, Tripura, Sikkim, and of course, Assam. This is a unique gathering at a CII function. That is only because you are being felicitated. That is because you have connected with the people of every part of this country. This is one quality which makes you very special among the people of this country, including us in industry. Sir, we have had the good fortune to work with you during your varied roles in India's governance structure. We've always been deeply impressed by your willingness to listen to all points of view and to accommodate diverse perspectives while formulating policies for inclusive growth and development. In particular, you have always been sympathetic to the perspectives of Indian industry, and through your painstaking efforts, you have crafted the environment for facilitating business. Your command of diverse areas of interest of the national discourse set a new level of engagement in government echelons. In your capacity as Cabinet Minister of Commerce, shortly after the reforms were initiated, you could configure national policies in a manner that would both protect and promote Indian industry amid a period of rapidly increasing globalization. As Minister of External Affairs, you put the interests of Indian industry at the heart of international negotiations, enabling the most ambitious ventures that we have taken overseas. Your support and encouragement has been a constant pole star in our endeavors, and we take this opportunity to reiterate our gratitude and appreciation to you. It is a matter of national priority to return to this high trajectory within a short time, so as to attain the national goal of inclusive growth. Sir, CII has involved a national vision of India at 75 that envisages our country as a powerhouse for the world and an ethical and technological leader by 2022. The vision has been developed through multiple stakeholder consultations and dialogue with a cross-section of society. CII believes that equality of opportunities, individual rights, and implementation will be critical for India to achieve its aspirations. India can actively shape the world order through economic strength, technological vitality, and moral leadership. Our management of diversity stands as a beacon for the rest of the world. It is in realizing this dream for India at 75 that we would seek your guidance and direction. India is clearly a leader in many spaces, and the world recognizes that. But there are some challenges that need yet to be addressed. These include, one, divides and disparities that remain in the country, regional and societal.